Spin their dance within your breath. Time runs its race within your head. My mind runs wild to comprehend. No mind on earth could understand. Sky spin. Sure. makes no sense, but this is grace. I know you're with me in this place. Here now, and all I know is I know that you are here now. Still my heart, let your voice be all I hear now. Spirit, breathe like the wind come up your way. 'Cause I know you're in this place. Makes a fool of what makes sense. But grace found my heart where logic ends. When justice called for all my debts, the friend of sinners came instead. Faith makes a fool. Called for all my debts, the friend of sinners came instead. Your ways are higher, your thoughts are wider. Love came like madness, poured out in blood, washed Romans. It makes no sense, but this is grace. I know you're with me in this place. Here now, all I know is I know that you are here now. So my heart, let your voice be all I. Yeah. is viola here now. Fix my eyes on the things that I can't see now. Spirit, breathe, let the wind come out your way. 'Cause I know that you thank you.
so much just for this night, God, to be able to come before you and sit and soak in your presence, Father. God, we thank you that your Holy Spirit is here, that you are here with us tonight, that it is through you and with you, God, that we have access to you. God, that we are able to connect with your heart, that we're able to meditate on your word and pray upon the things, Lord God, that are pleasing and precious to you. So God, we come before you tonight to just say thank you and to just learn more about you today. Amen. Tonight we'll be going into a time of worship in the word, and we encourage you to open up your Bibles to tonight's passage, which is John chapter 15, verses 1 through 17, and take this time to meditate on the word. John chapter 15, verses 1 through 3 state, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. Already you are clean because of the word that I have spoken to you. God, we thank you that you are the true vine, that you are the one that we can stand firm against, God, that we lean on for everything, Father. We thank you, Lord, that because of you, God, we're able to produce good fruit. God, we thank you that every branch that comes from you, God, every person that is connected to your heart, God, and in every way that we submit ourselves to you, Father, we will see ourselves to grow more and more in your Son's likeness. Father God, we thank you so much for the declaration of us being made pure, being made righteous, and being made holy through you. God, we pray that you keep us connected to you, God. Keep us connected to your heart. Keep us connected to your spirit. John chapter 15, verses 4 through 6 state, "Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is thrown away like a branch and withers, and the branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned." Father God, it's a privilege and an honor to know that you abide in us, God, and your desire is to abide in us. God, so we decide that we want to abide in you, Lord God. We want to be closer to you, Father God. Draw us near to you, Lord God. God, we want to be the branches that branch off of your vine, Father God, that bear the fruit, Lord God. After you've pruned us, God, after you've grown us and matured us, Father God, we want to bear fruit that looks more and more like you, God. We know that apart from you, we can do nothing, God. It is through you and with you that we have and do all things, God. We don't want to be thrown away. We don't want to be far away from you, God, but we desire to be closer and closer to you with every passing day, God. God, would you help us to abide in us? Would you help us to stay with you, God, and abide in you the way that you abide in us?
Free me.
Chapter 15, verses 7 through 8 state, "If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit and so prove to be my disciples." God, what a joy it is to continue to abide in you, and not just to know you, but also to know your words, God. That your words sit in our hearts, God, that they rest in our spirit, Lord. That we're able to use them and activate them, whatever comes our way, God. That we have the assurance, God, and we stand in the faith that when we come before you and pray, that you will do it because you are a good Father. God, and it's because of that fruit that we carry, God, that we are proof that you are a good and loving Father. Father, use us to be your proof on this earth. Use us to be your hands and your feet as we continue to do your work, God. As your kingdom comes here on this earth, Father God, let us be proof as we abide and rest in you, of your goodness, of your love, of your mercy, and your power.
To bring you glory.
Father, we thank you so much that you are the true vine, Father, and that as we abide in you, we learn more about your heart, God. We learn more about you, and that knowledge of you, Father God, draws us into even more of a deeper love for you. That we take your words, God, that we sit with them, that we meditate on them, Father God, and that they are as precious to us as you are. Father God, would your name be glorified by the fruit that we produce for you? And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
to this place in my life. I'm full, but I'm not satisfied. This longing to have more of you. My soul can't be quenched. You already know this, but still, come and do whatever you want to. And I'm standing knee deep, but I'm out where I've never been. I feel you come. Hear your voice on the wind. Won't you come and tear down the boxes that I have tried to put you in? Let love come, teach me who you are again. To the place where my heart was only about you, and all I wanted was just to be with you. Come and do whatever you want to. Further and further, my heart moves away. Further and Thank you.
Yeah, Father, we come before you, God, just to thank you for your sweetness of your presence, Father. To thank you, God, that as we sit with you, God, you pull us deeper and deeper into you. That there's nothing to fear in your presence. That there's nothing to hold back in your presence, God. God, that even in the midst of trials, God, even in the midst of uncertainty, Father God, it doesn't matter what our situations or our circumstances look like, Father God. We want to be completely surrendered to you. There's nothing more that we want, Father, but to just be completely immersed in your love. Father, would you continue to pull us and take us deeper into your word, God, deeper into your presence, deeper into who you are. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. At this time, we will transition into a time of intercession. And this evening, we will be lifting up the nation of Korea. I invite you to come into agreement with me as I lead out in prayer and follow along my prayers with your own intercession. Father, would you stir up a hunger in the nation of Korea, Father God, for your word? Father, we declare, Lord God, that apathy, religious tradition, Father God, are being broken off right now in the name of Jesus. And there's a hunger, Father God, for a deeper revelation of your word in your people of Korea, Father God. That as they come before you, as they read your word, Father God, would you enlighten their hearts, God? Would you reveal more as to who you are, God, in the fullness of your counsel, Father God? God, I pray for a dedication to your word, Father God, and a desire for it, God, to sit above all things. God, even the things that they know and that they've studied for years past, Father God, I pray that you would breathe new life into their devotional times, God. Would you give them, God, just a greater sensitivity for your word, God? Would you bring things to the surface, God, things unseen, things unlearned, God, to the surface, Father God, that they can go out in the ministry of the Holy Spirit? Father God, I declare that the people of Korea will experience a very deep and real satisfaction of you, Lord, through your word. Father God, that they would know you, that they would know your word, God, that it would be solidified in their hearts, Father God, for them to be able to minister, for them to be able to speak truth and life to everyone that they encounter. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Father, we pray for your people of Korea to be open and receptive to your truth, Father God, to the truth that is in your word, to not be distracted by situations and circumstances and lies from the enemy, God. God, I pray that they would be established in their truth as your sons and your daughters whom you've called, God. That the same way in which you poured out your spirit, Lord God, years ago, Lord God, and time after time, God, that you will continue to do the same in this nation. Father God, that you have not forgotten Korea, Lord God, that you have not allowed, Lord God, the enemy to come and attack them and devise them, Father God, forever, Lord God, but you have a greater destiny in store for Korea, God. God, I pray that you would give them ears to hear and eyes to see, God, and hearts to understand, Lord God, the biblical truths, Lord God, that you are calling Korea, Lord God, into a greater establishment of your word, Lord God, and bringing your kingdom forth, God. God, I pray that as they seek for knowledge, God, and as they dig for your truth, Father God, that they will steward that knowledge well, God, that they would teach it to others, Father God. I declare, Lord God, a hunger rising within the youth of Korea, Father God, to desire the truth and to chase after you, Father God, with everything that they have. Will they be the next generation, Father, who seeks to know you, who seeks to want you, who seeks to declare your name with power and authority and boldness, God? Let's pray. Religion to be replaced with the spirit of holiness, Father. Would you cause your people of Korea, Father God, to lay their sin down at your feet, Father God? Would you give them a revelation, Father God, that their sin, Lord God, is something that they need to turn away from, to repent, Lord God, and to seek your forgiveness and your salvation? God, that they would work out their own salvation, Father God, with fear and trembling. Father God, that they would work in the process, Father God, of becoming righteous, Lord God, before you. God, I pray for the sin and corruption to be revealed and uprooted in the heart of the church, God. God, I pray that through the true repentance of your people, God, the true repentance of the Church of Korea, Father, that they're able to stand and take their place as one whom you love, Lord God, that you have set apart in this area, Father God. God, I just declare right now that they're walking in holiness, Father God, that their desire, Lord God, is for your kingdom purity, Father God, to rest within their hearts and in their lives on a daily basis, God. I pray for that peace, Lord God, to come upon them, Father God. God, that true repentance, Lord God, that they will walk away from the things that have kept them from really seeking after your face, Lord God. God, we just declare right now, Lord God, and we prophesy over Korea, Lord God, that they will be a nation that is set apart. They will be a nation that is holy before you, Father God. And that all the earth, Lord God, will look towards Korea, Father God, both here in this place, Father God, and abroad, God. And they will see, Lord God, that you are a God who brings, Lord God, true forgiveness, salvation, God. Would your name be glorified. Let's pray. Father God, we pray that the scriptures, Lord God, will be open, Lord God, and that you will give a fresh revelation, Father God, and a hunger for your kingdom to come here in Korea, Father. God, would you pour out your spirit on your people today? We declare that hearts, Lord God, are hungering to see Korea unified in the way that you have designed it, God. God, that you desire unity, you desire families to be reconnected, God, that you desire for a oneness in this nation, God. We prophesy the spirit of unity across, Lord God, the churches in Korea as they pray and intercede on behalf of this nation, God. Despite denominations, God, despite anything that might be coming against them, Father God, to divide them, I pray for unity right now in the spirit. God, I declare that your kingdom will be established here in Korea and here on earth, God, that it will be evidence of your power and your authority and your love for your people here in Korea, God. We say, come, Holy Spirit. We say, your will be done here in Korea, God. Will Korea, Lord God, be a reflection of your kingdom, Father God? Let's pray. pray tonight for a hunger to begin to rise up in Korea, Lord, for a deep hunger for your word, God. Let them open the scriptures, Father God, and just find new things with each page, God, that will illuminate and point to who you are. Father God, I just pray for a hunger for truth, Father God, the truth in who you are, Father God, that they will know who they are and be established in identity as people, Lord God, that you have chosen here in Korea. Father God, that they will pour out, Lord God, just a heart of repentance before you, God, and seek to live a life that is holy and pleasing unto you. Father God, and we pray for your kingdom to come, Lord God, on earth as it is in heaven over Korea, God. Would you pour out your spirit on your people? God, would you just bring unity, Father God, amongst every single person, Lord God, who's interceding on behalf of Korea, God, that they will intercede, Lord God, and they will pray, Lord God, for the things that are on your heart. Father God, that we will all be united and all be one, Lord God, in our prayers, Lord God. God, I pray for this deep hunger to be rising, Lord God, and to not be satisfied, God, with anything but you. To not be satisfied with anything but your word, your truth, your holiness, and your kingdom. Father God, we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
It's time to see.
Presence, all heaviness, all weariness, all anxiety, all fear is lifted off. As we sing your praises, you take us deeper into your realms of glory. We thank you, Father. There's so much more of you for us to discover, so much more of you for us to know. It's our joy and it's our privilege to come into your presence. Know, God, that you are waiting for us. You're eagerly awaiting your sons and daughters to come to you with hunger and with desire. And as we lift up all these prayers for this nation, we know, Father, that you are listening, that you are leaning your ear towards us. And you long to hear the prayers of the saints being lifted up for this nation. We trust in your work. We trust in your ability to do exceedingly more than we could ever ask for or imagine. We trust, Father, that you are moving even right now. We thank you. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Thank you for joining us tonight. We hope that you are blessed. We hope that you are blessed. We hope that we'll see you once again next week. We have a watch Wednesday mornings at 9:30 in the morning. Otherwise, we'll see you once again here Thursday evening at 8 p.m. We hope that you have a wonderful rest of the night. And a wonderful weekend as well. See you again next week.
Thank you.